Well, good morning, boys and girls. My name is Pastor Ricardo, and I'm with Renewed Church. Thank you so much for tuning in. I have a wonderful lesson for you this morning, and it's about recognizing Jesus' voice. So right now, we're going to do a little game, and it's about identifying phrases with the character. Okay, so here's the first one. To infinity and beyond. Who says this phrase? Yes, it's Buzz Lightyear. Great job. Here's the second one. Some people are worth melting for. Yes, Olaf says that. Great job. Here's the third one. Just keep swimming. Yes, it's Dory. Man, you guys are doing great. Here's the fourth one. Me want cookie. Yes, it's the Cookie Monster. Man, you guys are amazing. And here's the final one. There's no place like home. Yes, that is Dorothy. Man, great job. Man, if you were able to identify all these five phrases and characters, man, that means that you've watched these movies. And you know the phrases and characters really good. But I also have to remind you that maybe some of you were not able to get all of them. For example, if you've never watched the movie Finding Nemo, then you probably wouldn't have recognized the phrase, just keep swimming. But if you watched the movie Frozen so many times, then you'll recognize the phrase that Olaf says. So here's what I want you to know, that the more you watch these movies and characters, the more you understand and know their voices. So I have one more voice for you to guess. And here's the voice. Love each other as I loved you. Who says that? Yes, it was Jesus. That is correct. You see, Jesus is not a cartoon character. You see, Jesus is a good shepherd that takes care of us. And so I'm going to read to you John chapter 10, verse 4. And it says, when he has brought out all his own sheep, he goes in front of them. The sheep follow him because they know his voice. You see, boys and girls, you know the job of a shepherd is to take care of his sheep. And he provides for them. He provides food every single day for these sheep. He also protects them. He protects them from the wolves. He protects them from the lions and the bears. You know, he is all around the provider for these sheep. And there are times that he takes him out into walks. And see, and I love what he says here, that he has brought out all his own sheep. He goes in front of them. So when the shepherd goes in front of the sheep, he knows where to go. He knows the path to take, and that path is safe. So the story behind this verse is that Jesus is our shepherd and we are his sheep. In other words, that Jesus takes care of us. He knows what we need. He knows that the food that we need. He knows that we need shelter. He knows that we need a home to be in. And so God will shelter us. He will take care of us. He will keep us safe because we are his child. And so as a father, I want to make sure that my kids have all that they need. And so Jesus will do the same for us because we are his sheep. You know, he is our shepherd and he will take care of us and provide and keep us safe from the danger that's in the world. And that danger is Satan. Satan is the one that wants to destroy us. And our Father in heaven wants to protect us and take care of us from these bad wolves. Amen? And so I love that verse. And so what I want you to get from all of this conversation that we're having is that those who belong to God will recognize his voice. Amen. So I would like to pray for you this morning. I know it's a short lesson, but it's also a valuable lesson for us to understand that, you know, that we can hear his voice. So how do we hear his voice? Well, it's real simple. Is that we have to read the word of God every day, and we have to pray to Jesus every single morning and every single night. So when we pray and when we read the word of God, we can hear his voice and we can understand what he's trying to do to us. And he will make a path for us, because it's going to be a safe path. It's not going to be a path that will get us in trouble or be dangerous, because he is our shepherd and we are his sheep, and he will safeguard us. He will make sure that we are safe. Okay? So let me pray with you this morning. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you that you are a shepherd and we are your sheep. You take care of us. You provide for us. You give us food. You give us shelter. You give us, God, what we need. And so I thank you that we can talk to you through prayer. We can read your word of God, and you can help us just, you know, be in the right path. And so we love you, and we're so thankful, God, for all that you do for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, thank you so much for being here with us. I have one challenge for you this morning. It's real simple. All I want you to do this week is I want you to draw a picture of something, okay, of an object. It can be a flower. It can be, you can draw a bike. You can draw whatever you want, okay? And I want you to take a picture of it, and I want you to share it, okay, with us at Renew Miami, okay? And then whoever draws the best, we will give you a $20 gift card, okay? So that is it. Oh, man, my goodness, I forgot to tell you another rule about this drawing. And I apologize, I totally forgot about this. But you have to be blindfolded in order for you to win this prize, okay? So make sure, moms and dads, that you put a blindfold on your kids. They cannot look. You can help them, okay? You can help them, guide them through this, but please, boys and girls, no peeking. It's gotta be blindfolded, okay? And whoever draws the best, we will give you a $20 gift card, okay? Well, God bless you. Thank you so much for being here with us, and we'll see you next week. God bless you.